Hello, this is Sebastian Ament, and we'll be presenting together with John Ryan. We're both PhD candidates at Kernel University, and we'll be talking about exploiting structure in kernel matrices. So first, why do we care about kernel methods? Kernel methods are used widely in machine learning, statistics, and applied mathematics. Examples include Gaussian processes, the T-distributed stochastic neighborhood embedding, or in short, T-SNE, and many more like kernel clustering and kernel PCA. All of these methods rely on the computations with a kernel matrix, for example, matrix multiplication or matrix solves. And generally, this is hard to scale to large data sets because of at least quadratic memory and computational complexity, unless the matrix has special structure that we can exploit. And fortunately, we can draw inspiration for such a structure exploiting function from Julia Base. In particular, we were inspired by the implementation of factorize in Julia Base, which can detect certain matrix structures at runtime, even with a generic matrix as input, and employ specialized algorithms depending on the structure. For example, matrix A here is generic with no particular structure, and the factorization FA is an LU decomposition. B is a symmetric positive definite matrix for which factorize returns the more efficient Cholesky decomposition. And C is the identity matrix, but cast into a generic dense matrix type so that multiple dispatch alone cannot detect it. But still, factorize returns a diagonal type. And our goal here is to enable similarly intelligent factorizations for kernel matrices. And the first difficulty we encounter here is that merely instantiating a kernel matrix costs O of n squared operations for n data points, which is prohibitively large for large n. We can avoid this with a special matrix type that represents the matrix lazily, only stores the kernel function and the data, and delays the evaluation of the kernel elements until required. On the right, we see a code snippet that initializes 16,000 data points, a covariance kernel function, and a lazy representation of the Gramian kernel matrix. On the bottom, we can see that initialization of G is virtually instantaneous and requires no memory allocation. Further, lazy multiplication only allocates the target vector and is significantly faster than instantiating G densely and subsequently multiplying with the dense matrix. Now, based on this lazy representation, we can talk about the structure of our proposed factorization routine. And this factorization routine follows a decision tree that executes different paths for different types of kernel and data properties. So first, we check if the data set is small. And if it is, we can still perform multiplications lazily, but also perform dense factorizations such as Cholesky or LU. But given a large data set, we further check the following. So if the kernel decays quickly with respect to a distance measure like the Euclidean norm, then the corresponding kernel matrix is very likely approximately sparse with many entries close to, but not identical to zero. And for this reason, we attempt to create a sparse approximation to the matrix. So the sparse approximation to the full kernel matrix can be found by putting a threshold on the distance beyond which the kernel is approximately zero. And this means we don't have to instantiate the full matrix, since points that are inside a certain range around another point can be found very efficiently with tree-based domain decomposition algorithms like those provided in nearestneighbors.jl. And as an example, we can see a schematic of a dense kernel matrix and its sparse approximation on the right. And the sparsity pattern that's detected can then be used to accelerate matrix multiplication and solves, for example, using an iterative solver like the conjugate gradient method. Cutting to you, John.
Thanks, Sebastian. So if the kernel doesn't decay quickly, but the dimensionality is relatively moderate, for example, less than 70, we use a recently developed algorithm known as the fast kernel transform. The fast kernel transform is a new fast approximation algorithm used by our package. This technique can be thought of as a generalization of the Barnes-Hutt method. It's analogous to the fast Gauss transform or the fast multiple method in that it uses analytic expansions of the kernel to compute approximate low rank representations of blocks of the kernel matrix with controllable accuracy and without the need for any algebraic matrix factorization, such as a QR factorization or an interpolative decomposition. Further, the FKT is based on a new analytic expansion, which works for general isotropic kernel functions. And it only depends on derivatives of the kernel, which we can compute using the Taylor series.jl package. With the fast kernel transform, matrix vector multiplication runs in n log n time, where n is the number of data points. Now, if the dimensionality is high, the kernel decays slowly, and the number of points is high, then we perform a general matrix vector multiplication using lazy calls to the kernel function, and linear solves are performed iteratively. In addition to what's shown here on this slide, our package has a few extra hooks as well for special cases of matrices, such as when the kernel matrix is tuplets or circulant, and fast Fourier transforms can be performed leveraging lazy kernel function calls. On this slide, we review two experiments which leverage the tools in the fast kernel matrices package. The first experiment is a T-SNE implementation for clustering MNIST images of digits between 0 and 9. This experiment used the fast kernel transform for the Cauchy kernel matrix, which appears in the repulsive component of T-SNE, and approximate sparsification for the Gaussian kernel matrix, which appeared in the attractive component of T-SNE. In the second experiment, the Gaussian process regression for sea surface temperature data, we use the fast kernel transform for the Matern kernel matrix.
And with that, we thank you for your attention and hope to talk to you at JuliaCon. Bye-bye.